Hey everybody, how's it going? Check it out. Upon successful completion of this video, hopefully I'm going to show you how to fix your Ram Promaster no squirt windshield wiper fluid on the windshield scenario problem.
I like peanut butter, I like peanut butter, peanut butter, I like peanut butter.
Yeah, so here's the problem. Let me show you. Well, that's embarrassing. Half of it works. Go, hold on. Just a couple minutes ago, after I gathered the equipment necessary to clear a possible blockage of your windshield wiper fluid reservoir, none of the nozzle jets were working, but evidently now the driver side is working, which is good for me, the driver, but not good for the passenger. So I guess at this point, I'm just going to go ahead and show you what you would need to do to possibly clear it, or at least how I would clear a windshield wiper fluid reservoir, fill tube, whatever, blockage. Okay, so if you're not able to squirt windshield wiper fluid up on your windshield, this is where you fill it in a Promaster. If you'll take a good look, you need to look to see if you have any fluid in there. In this case, mine is full with the Rain-X stuff that I enjoy, so it's not a problem of it being empty, right? So that's one thing. So you have to locate where the nozzles are in order to be able to squirt the stuff on the windshield. Well, here's one up here, and it's loose, and here's the other one. Now, the reason why that one is loose is real simple. I need to check to see if this one's plugged. Now, we know that it's not, but this is what you would do. So you just grab it and you work it out. Now, there's the hose that connects to the nozzle. We're going to call it the nozzle jet. All right. So what you'd want to do is to pull this off and maybe put a little bit of air pressure through it to see if it's plugged. So you just pull it. It comes off pretty easy. You pull it, and you go like this. Anyway, it's clear now. So there you go. If you have debris in there, you probably just blew it out. Now keep in mind, the stuff doesn't taste very well, so don't swallow it, don't drink it, don't do anything stupid like that. Anyway, so this has air going through it. So it's obviously not plugged at the nozzle. Now you'd want to do this on both sides. So if you do one, and it blows clear and you do the other one and it doesn't, then there you go. You got to figure out your issue and kind of clear it from there. But usually it's pretty apparent that if it's going to be one or the other, you'll know. In other words, one will squirt on the windshield. Okay, so I've got it pushed back on. I'm going to push it back down into place to make sure it's locked like that. And now I'll test it. Here we go. Nope. All right, so that was kind of weird. The left side worked, the right side did not. I blew through and cleared the left side just to show you, and then the right side, and now neither is working very well. So at this point, I'm thinking that there's a blockage in the line, in a little tube that actually takes the windshield wiper fluid from the reservoir up and squirts it on the windshield. So how do you fix that? Well, the secret is going to be air. I'm going to take some air and blow it back down through the line so that hopefully if it's a drain, a blockage, that maybe it'll clear itself at the pump. Now, if you do something like this, you certainly run the risk of blowing whatever it is back down there, probably sediment, hard water, who knows. Even though I only try to use distilled water, I know that sounds stupid, but that's how you eliminate hard water. So I do run the risk of blowing sediment back down into the pump itself, and maybe that won't work. It might cause damage to the pump, it might not. I've done this before, and I've never had this issue, but who knows, man. Today may be my day. So what I'm going to use is this small pancake compressor. This thing will do 150 PSI. I certainly don't need that going inside there, so I'll dial it down. But you want to use some kind of air. If you have a compressor, maybe a tire pump inflator, maybe that'll work. I don't know. But I'm going to take that and a hose, and I'm going to stick it into the nozzle jet hose. I'll show you in just a second, and I'm just going to push a little air back through. here we go. And it looks like it did not fix it. All right, so full disclosure, it's been about a day or two because we actually took, it's been a little bit longer than that. We actually went to a paranormal convention, so I couldn't quite fix it. But where we left off was is that the nozzles were spraying, but they weren't really spraying. And at that point, here's what we've determined. We've determined that the pump actually works and that the reservoir is not plugged. And so it really boiled down to the nozzles. So the nozzles themselves need to be cleaned. Yeah. So I took a little bit of compressed air and sprayed them, and they spray a little bit better. But at this point, I'm going to take the nozzles off, and I think I'm going to go ahead and put them in a little cup with some white vinegar. Because if it's like a hard water type situation, or if it's some kind of soapy debris, or if it's something like that, that's obviously larger than the diameter of the spray nozzle hole, vinegar should take care of it. So I'm going to pull both the nozzles off, and I'm going to soak them in some white vinegar for probably about an hour or so, and then I'm going to give it a try and see if that actually will take care of it. Okay, so here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to put one drop of Dawn Blue. Okay, well, that's a little bit more than a drop, but that's okay. I'm going to put our little nozzles. I'm just going to reuse this old water bottle. And I'm going to dump some just regular white distilled vinegar in it. Not too much, just enough to cover. There we go. Look how floaty. So I'm going to... Basically, I'm just going to agitate a little bit to make sure it gets in there. Now I'm going to let it sit. Okay, so it's been about an hour. Water's pretty cloudy. Well, I shouldn't say water. Vinegar. Vinegar, a little bit of Dawn. These things have been sitting about an hour. Look at all that cloudy stuff coming in here. I'm hoping that's just maybe hard water and soap that got inside and clogged the nozzles. All right, so let's put them back on and see what happens. So it looks like cleaning them out has done the trick. Use a little just white vinegar. I put a drop of Dawn in there, agitate them for a little bit, let it soak. It seems to be working just fine. However, my spray pattern is way higher up on the windshield than where I want it. So I'm going to take a second and show you how to adjust them, and that should take care of it. Okay, so to adjust these, on the side of the windshield sprayer nozzle doodad is a little slot, looks like a flathead screw. And when you turn that, it takes the spray and makes it go up or down on the windshield. So what you need is a very small sort of flathead screwdriver to give it just a little tweak. See, the angle of it is way high, so I'll just put the screwdriver and just gently turn it down just a little bit. So if you look at the slot, so if the slot of the screw is like that, it's gonna be high up in the windshield, but when it goes down or you turn it, the spray goes accordingly. So that's probably a little too far down, but I'm gonna go with it. Now this one's the same way. See the slot on this one? Is going that way. So up on the windshield is towards the middle. So this one's pretty good actually. So I may leave this one alone. Okay, here we go. Ooh, nice. About halfway up the windshield. Okay. So anyway, hey, I appreciate you taking time to watch this video. comment, like, subscribe, share, all that good stuff, make videos all the time. So, for my next video, I'm going to do a review of a generator that I bought. Yeah, this guy right here, made by Pulsar. It's very nice, and I'm going to tell you all about it. So anyway, thank you very much. See you later. Take it easy. Bye-bye.